Well, I'm here on the River Carron. It's 16th of March, second day of the official brown trout season. I wanted to get out yesterday, but it was absolutely blowing a gale. It's snowing up a lot better today, but I thought, well, give it a go, see if it's better down in the valley. And right enough, it's actually not too bad here. So, I'm going to have a wee go, my first cast of the season, see how we get on. I've never been here before, I've utterly no idea what works, so I'm going to do a wee bit kick sample first. If there's anything interesting, I'll get it on video. And I'm actually just watching this wee bit of river here, and I can see a few flies coming off actually. Don't see any fish, but I certainly see flies. I'll turn the camera around and let you have a look. Flies just in there. I see stuff on the surface just there. I don't have the camera, I'll pick it up, but I can certainly see them. Nice wee glide right down there. And another wee swing bit, so hopefully it's deep enough and maybe something in there. I'll run some bugs through it and a wee wet fly.
Well, here's the wee assortment of beasties I got for my kick sample. So there was a huge stone fly and an absolutely massive black and yellow it was, but it fell off the net as I was picking it out of the water, but I got a good look at it. It was utterly huge. But I've got a couple of wee things here. I think that's like an uncased caddis, that wee green thing, and a couple of big olive seems to be the colour, to be honest. Everything's olive. There's no sort of browniness about anything here. Very interesting. I like doing this. It's good. Got a good idea. Plenty of life though. That was just a couple of wee kicks. And well, spoonful of variety of bugs, so we have an idea what we can go with. Let's get fishing.
I think I had a fish there. I had my first three fish through there. Very deep at the far side. Sort of spot you would think it would probably have fish, and there's certainly flies coming up. Watching them drifting down in the faster water. Wee upwinds, wee March Browns or something like that. And I'm pretty certain I seen a fish rise down the bottom there. And I went to cover it with the bugs. And it felt like I had a take, but I don't know if maybe the bottom fly had snagged on the bottom. It is quite snaggy. I'm in a bit of a quandary really. If I put smaller sort of bugs on or smaller nymphs, the wind's catching the line. I'm using a French leader and the wind's catching the line and it's sort of holding them up on the surface. If I put something heavier on the point, which is getting me down, and I'm able to cast into the wind a wee bit, I'm getting snagged all the time. It doesn't look especially snaggy looking into it, but clearly there's enough there to catch the flies, and I'm just getting caught up all the time. I'm pretty certain I got a knock. It felt like a right head shake, and then the line just sort of went solid and then it came free. I think it probably got, I got snagged on something. I'm pretty certain I hooked into a fish there, I'm positive of that. But certainly there was something rising. I'm almost tempted to put a convention, just to change back to conventional leader and put a, maybe a, something like a jingler with a wee nymph under it or something like that. Just to try and hold the flies up off the bottom, but give them the depth and also a indication if anything's there, and you never know, something on the top. There's certainly that was a fish down the bottom that definitely goes. So, but this flies, so have a wee think and we have a wee watch for a wee while and see what happens. Excellent. A nice fish too. Nice fish. On the nymph, under the dry. Yeah, first brownie of the season. Duck broken. Nice wee fish. Pound, maybe 3/4 of a pound. Try and get a picture. First fish in a dry fly, came up as slow as you like and just sucked the clink hammer right off the surface. Oh, it was excellent, absolutely excellent. Here we come. Fish, but I'll tell you what, he took that absolute magic. I seen him coming from underwater, just the gold rising up, and he took the wee clink hammer that I've been fishing as an indicator, just sucked it off. Could see that coming the whole way. There we go, another cracking wee brownie. Two on my first day, superb. Off you go. Absolutely brilliant. Didn't even bother putting my head cam back on because I never thought I had a chance.
That's me, had a wee day on the cam, a couple of hours anyway. It's been good. I've ended up with two fish that I really wasn't expecting. I fished through this wee section first and I did see a fish move down the bottom there, and I'm positive I hooked it. And in fact, the fish that I caught first was in exactly the same lie. I think it was the same fish. And I'd go so far as to say that I did hook it because it had a wee bit of torn mouth. I suspect that I'm right enough what I thought happened. I got snagged on the bottom and I think the fish has managed to pull itself off the hook, but it's torn its mouth in the process. But I decided just on the way back there I would fish the same wee bit using the clink hammer with the two wee nymphs under it, just to try it a different way, and having given it a rest for a couple of hours. And first cast, that fish took the tiny wee size 16 nymph off the bottom and got that in. No sooner had I done that, first cast over a wee bit further up, and the fish just came from miles away. I seen it coming from deep. I just seen the flash of gold and I thought, you're coming, that's a fish coming up for the fly. And it just took it as slow as you like off the surface. Absolutely brilliant. Took the brown clink hammer, wee pheasant tail clink hammer that I was using as a sort of sighter. I was hopeful I might get something, at least interest on the top, because as I say, I'd seen that fish move down there and had been a couple of bit,
couple of upwings coming off, probably March Browns or whatever, couldn't really see them that close, but so, been very worthwhile. Two fish on my first day on a river this season, 16th of March. Can't knock that, really. Can't knock that. So, going to sign off now, head home for pasta bake. Catch you later.